All I need to do is draw a single line and it's crashed again. Hello internet, and this is a video on what animation software you should use if you're just beginning and you are too cheap to pay for software. On screen are three different programs we will discuss in this video, and let's start with OpenToonz. OpenToonz is an open source version of Toons developed by Digital Video in Italy. Features from the paid version trickle down into this version, which is always nice. When you first open OpenToonz and try the brush tool, you will probably want to uninstall. The default brush settings I found were pretty bad. With a little tweaking though, I was able to make it like other software packages. After that, it still had its quirks, but it was certainly more than capable to help you produce a simple bouncy ball animation with ease. Many people use the paid version of Toons, which OpenToonz is based upon. Productions include Futurama, the movie Polto, and more. There are too many features to go through in a single video, although I'll be making more OpenToonz tutorials in the future. Next up is FireAlpaca. I only recommend it to those who want to produce bitmap animation quickly, doing frame by frame. FireAlpaca is very basic when it comes to animation. There's no timeline, only layers. However, I find this personally appealing when I want to animate something very quickly, without thinking about the tools I need to use. Select the brush, all the settings are automatically perfect. Draw something, create a new layer, draw something else, using the onion skin as a reference, rinse and repeat. To enable the onion skin, go to View, Onion Skin Mode. To preview the animation, go to View, Autoplay. Voila! And what if you want multiple layers for a single frame of animation? Create a new folder. A folder acts as a single frame. What? Flash costs money, I hear you cry. Well, in April 2005, Adobe acquired the whole of Macromedia and its assets. That includes Macromedia Flash. How is this important? Adobe recently closed down activation servers for Macromedia Flash MX 2004 and thus released the keys on their website. Flash MX 2004 is obviously not the latest version by any stretch of the imagination. However, it certainly is usable in 2017 as a free alternative to Animate CC. Missing features include graphical filters, blend modes, ActionScript 3, bones, HTML5, variable width, stroke, custom brushes, sprite sheet, generator, a WebGL, and exporting as a GIF. But how much of that does the average animator actually need? The main thing that may disappoint is graphical filters and blend modes, but they can always be added in a different program. It may be more tedious, but for free, what can you expect? Other than those compromises, I would recommend Flash MX 2004. It's not my favourite animation experience, but it's certainly miles above animating in MS Paint and importing those into Windows Movie Maker. Hopefully, this has given you a few ideas as to what software to use for free when beginning your animation journey. Next week, there will be a video on best paid animation software packages, but until then, thanks for watching. Hope you tune in next week. All comments and ratings are appreciated. Like this video. All that online video gumph. Goodbye.